Hey everybody, welcome back to another Chippa in the third person. Patreon.com/thechippa. The Chippa made this is what I call these podcasts, which are the Chippa Brothers Tangent, Creating Geeks, Shooting the Shit with Chippa, and the Talkbuster podcast, which got some exciting interviews lined up very shortly for you guys on. And tonight, the second episode with Sandy Harding, the store manager of the last Blockbuster on the planet in Bend, Oregon, drops for everybody. So tonight at 11 p.m., all of you can listen to it. If you still want to get a one-up on your friends and listen to it early, you can hit up my Patreon. Just $1 a month gets you all this cool content. I mean, you get it anyway, but you get early access. And what's a dollar? Do it. Come on. A buck. A candy bar. Anyway, what's been going on? So, I just watched the Death Stranding trailer this morning. I've lost touch of things outside of Nintendo on new video games, but I've been following along with the development of this one. Hideo Kojima, the Metal Gear Solid guy, amongst other things, and Guillermo del Toro were supposed to be making a Silent Hill game together. That little demo that they had was fantastic. I'm bummed out that we didn't get to get that game, but it really looks like they learned a lot and are continuing a lot of that blatant creepiness and imagery into whatever the hell Death Stranding is. So there's this 8 to 9 minute release trailer. It's got Mads Mikkelsen, Norman Reedus, a bunch of other people playing very, very, very close to photorealistic. I'd say they look probably as good or a little better than the first Uncanny Valley motion capture film stuff, but it's actual gameplay footage, man. This is a gorgeous looking game. I'm not so sure if I am 100% believing or liking exactly how the visual aesthetic and strange creepiness that's going on fits into the actual gameplay, but the gameplay looks exciting to me. It has a kind of a cross of Zelda and Fallout kind of look to what's going on. It looks really, really complex and really, really fun to play. I can't wait. Unfortunately, I don't have a PS4, so hey, Movie Bob, guess what? I'm going to be coming over to play Death Stranding a bunch because I don't have enough time to warrant a brand new console. But color me very, very, very intrigued and impressed, especially since the game's coming out so quick. We're getting it this fall, right? This winter, November. That's freaking bonkers. Especially since that Silent Hill game in development, then not in development, wasn't so long ago. So, welcome back, Hideo Kojima. Can't wait to see what you do on your own outside of Konami, because that was quite a clusterfuck. And really looking forward to Death Stranding, even though I have no fucking idea what's going on. And maybe that's the point. So anyway, that's Death Stranding. Recorded the Kevin Smith Smackdown with the folks over at Geeks with Shields last night. I'm really looking forward to hearing what you guys think. In true to us fashion, we didn't get fully through it. We left the last two films to be discussed on another podcast. Good news, that means that we get to all go and revisit, and one of the guys didn't actually get to one of them, which was kind of a bummer. But that's okay, because it gives us a chance to regroup and have a decent conversation about those last two films. I think you're all going to be very pleased and also very surprised by the two movies that ended up at the top of the pack and what movies made it through to the finals. So be following the folks over at Geeks with Shields. They're great friends of mine and also patrons of mine and co-conspirators in this internet podcast, Geeky Insanity. And so look forward to that. Next on the docket is, like a lot of people that have been blowing up about it on Twitter and elsewhere lately, I just finished watching The Perfection. Whoa. spoiler alert right now, if you want to go in cold into the perfection, I recommend going in cold. I had no fucking idea what it was about, and I don't think the movie had any real intention of letting you know really what it's about till the last, like, 15 minutes or so. It keeps bait and switching on genre and tone and how over the top versus how subdued it's going to be. Is it an erotic thriller? Is it a straight-up gore horror movie? Is it a psychological mind trip? Is there, you know, religious cults and devil stuff involved, which is kind of trickled in there with the intentions of the villains in the film? Is there a disease that the people that are visiting Hong Kong or China keep getting? Or is that just a happenstance that happens to work in the favor of what's going on with the main characters? But, yeah. So, long and short of it, because, man, this movie's fucking tweaked. The Perfection. It's about a woman named Charlotte who went and attended this very prestigious music school, which is run out of a couple's home. It's like a mansion kind of home. And, you know, it's been a family tradition to run this, and she was the best of the best. And she had to leave because her mother was sick, so the movie opens with a lot of interleaved back and forth, between the past and the future, or the past and the current, of her, you know, being home and, you know, watching her mother deteriorate. And she then is left, okay, what do I do now? And the movie starts off with making it seem like a positive. She goes and reconnects with the people that owned this school and meets their new protege, their new her, basically. And they have this, you know, first starts off as, you know, admiration, friendship turns into a fling, and then she agrees to go on a trip with her. This girl's got, like, her first two-week vacation. And it's around that time where the intention starts seeming a little bit deliberate from Charlotte towards Lizzie. There's a lot of overly helpfulness, and they've established in the scene the night before that there's some disease going around that's been getting people really sick. And so when Lizzie wakes up after their fling, you know, she asks for some ibuprofen, she's got a splitting headache, you think it's just, you know, that she's hungover, right? And everything Charlotte is doing for her, they keep intercutting, like, quick jump shots of, like, more evil, or, like, not evil, but, like, Charlotte as a kid, like, freaking out in the chair watching her mom, and, you know, there's shots that start alluding to the fact that it's not necessarily what you're thinking is going on. So, is it that the school is evil and Lizzie is bad and she's going to do something to Charlotte, or Charlotte is jealous? And so what it comes down to is they're on the bus and Lizzie starts getting sick and puking everywhere, and when Charlotte looks, she sees, they both see in her puke that there's bugs in it. She's like, okay, I have this disease, and this is fucking graphic and intense shit for a Netflix or more mainstream spook film or, you know, thriller. So it's interesting. The bus driver eventually kicks them off the bus. She says, it feels like they're crawling in my head, they're crawling in my skin. She looks down and says, they're crawling in my arm. Charlotte says, look, there's bugs. The bugs start coming out of her arm and moving over to her hand. Charlotte then pulls a butcher knife out. Don't worry, they get to where that came from. But then she looks at her and goes, you know what you have to do, Lizzie. And Lizzie cuts her own hand off. So, move forward to a little bit more in the future. 3 months, I believe it is. Lizzie shows up back at the house of these music teachers, and surprise, surprise, with her missing her hand, she's unable to play. She's unable to achieve the perfection, as they allude to. And they kick her out. They agree to pay for her housing and everything, but she's nothing to them anymore. This obviously sends her into a friggin' outrage. She tracks down around Charlotte and beats the shit out of her. And we leave it at that. What they reveal in this cool, like, rewind thing that they do during this, actually they do it back when she's first at the house with the people, because when she comes to, is that Charlotte had given her mom's medication, which mixed with alcohol can cause hallucinations. She used that mixed with the fear of the disease going around to her, to, like, help her, drive her to ruin herself. What she originally believes, and the teachers try to tell her, is the reason for this, is that she's done it out of jealousy. But what she eventually says to her, and is revealed later, is she's done it to save her from them. And they keep alluding to what that means. And with that, the movie just gets weirder and weirder. And I'm not going to blow where it goes other than to say, one, if you're triggered by things like abuse and insinuated abuse, torturistic type things, ultra violence, this movie goes from not showing the violence to horrifically over the top, oh my god, wow, fuck, ultra violence insanity in the third act, that I'm not going to say is for everyone. So if these types of things bother you, stay away. But if you want a good old-fashioned revenge flick and you don't really know going in who's getting the revenge on who, and it's very twisty and very layered and very well done and very well acted, the perfection is for you. It's bonkers, and I absolutely dug it. So with that, thank you for joining me. This has been the Chippa, and I'll see you guys on the other side. Bye.